Wander Wealthy Podcast, episode 175. Oh, hello, hello, everyone. Welcome back to another episode of the Wander Wealthy Podcast. My name is Tess Wicks. I am your host, founder of Wander Wealthy, and business coach, business mentor, if you will, to all of the new money coaches of the world, the aspiring money coaches of the world, and even those who have been doing and working on and trying to build your money coaching business, but might just be a little bit frustrated with your progress, with the results that you've been getting. If you fall into one of those three categories, then welcome. You are in the right place. So today's podcast episode is just a little bit more of an introduction into my philosophy behind building a coaching business. It's the one that I use and infuse into the Wealthy Coach Blueprint, which is my 12-week business coaching program for money coaches, financial coaches, wealth coaches, whatever you call yourself. And it is really, and when I think about it, it really boils down to this idea of the one and only marketing funnel that you need. And I'm going to go ahead and explain what a marketing funnel is, especially for those of you who are new to business, to online business especially. But before I do, the reason I want to talk about this like one and only marketing funnel that you need is because marketing and sales are the two key pieces to building your booked out coaching business. And what I talk about in the Wealthy Coach Blueprint specifically is you get a crash course in marketing and selling your program. You also get taught how to build your amazing life-changing program for your ideal client and how to find your ideal client and all of that jazz. But then once you've nailed down who your ideal client is, you've created this amazing life-changing program, then it comes to actually A, talking about your program and getting your program in front of the right people, which is marketing, and B, selling your program, which is sales, getting people in and buying your program. So those two pieces are super important once you've gone through the ideation phase of coming up with a program and identifying your ideal client. Then this is the gap that we have to bridge between you having a great idea and you being actually a successful and thriving coach with a full roster of clients. Now, there is another piece to this that I also include inside of the Wealthy Coach Blueprint. Once you do have your fully booked out roster of clients, there is, of course, being an awesome coach and how to, you know, provide your clients with an amazing and actual life-changing experience, following through on your promise. And then, of course, managing your business and stepping into the CEO role, but that really comes after we get through and over the gap of how do we, you know, go from an idea to having a business. And that's where marketing and sales really comes in. And so obviously there's many phases in building this business, and that's all included in the Wealthy Coach Blueprint, which is the sponsor of this week's episode and this entire podcast. If you want to learn more, you can head to wanderwealthy.com/apply. Right now, enrollment is closed, but it will be opening very soon in August for the next round of students, of clients who want to go through the blueprint and build their booked out money coaching business. So head to wanderwealthy.com/apply. You can learn so much more about the blueprint, and you can jump on the waitlist, which is the perfect place to be if you're interested in building your thriving booked out coaching business and you want to be one of the first to know when enrollment for the Wealthy Coach Blueprint is open, because it is first come, first serve, and I do have to cap the number of students that I can serve in each round. So wanderwealthy.com/apply. Now, today I really wanted to dive into the thing that I had mentioned, the only marketing funnel that you need, because I do think that marketing is such an important part of building a business. And it's an interesting part because I think a lot of people get really tripped up in that area. And when we talk about marketing, we're talking about, you know, knowing where your clients are, where your ideal clients are hanging out. They're not clients yet, but knowing where they are, getting in front of them, and then being able to show them that you are an authority figure in this space, that you are someone who they should know, who eventually they will like, and eventually they can trust. And marketing is really all about finding them, knowing where they hang out, getting in front of them, and then creating content that they see on a regular basis and that makes them go, oh, this person is legit, and oh, they're talking about this program, and oh, I think that program might be perfectly suited for me. And so when we talk about a marketing funnel, and specifically as it relates to online marketing, what we're really talking about is the way for a business owner to get in front of and then guide potential customers through a buying process. And in the Wealthy Coach Blueprint, I go through the buyer's journey and show you my only marketing funnel that I use in my business and how you can take a client through this buyer's journey and ultimately take them from complete strangers to people who are obsessed with your program and love everything that you do. And that is ultimately what we talk about when we talk about a marketing funnel. The problem is, and like I had said, so many people get tripped up when it comes to marketing their online business, and specifically those money coaches out there. They get so tripped up when it comes to marketing. And I say this because I've talked to you and I know that this is where you're stuck. And I've also been there too. So here's what typically happens. You come up with this great idea to create a program and help other people, and you want to get it in their hands. And so you start your research and you figure out, oh, okay, in order to take people down the kind of general concept of a marketing funnel, taking people from strangers to ultimately knowing about you to then wanting to work with you and buying your stuff, you have to start a blog. And then you start a blog and you're going with your blog, and then you're like, I'm not getting the traction I want, so I'm going to start a podcast too. And you start your podcast, and now you're doing a blog and a podcast, and you're like, oh, okay, I also need to make sure I'm promoting this amazing content that I'm creating on my blog and my podcast, and so I'm going to do that on Pinterest. And you start using Pinterest, but then you're like, I really like to use Instagram also, and I know Facebook is where it's at, so I'm going to be using Pinterest, Instagram, and Facebook. And so you have your blog, you have your podcast, you are promoting the amazing content you're creating there on Pinterest, on Instagram, and on Facebook. And then you figure out, maybe you sign up for another freebie, or you just, maybe you work with a coach, or you sign up for a course that tells you, you know where it's at, you know how you get clients. You actually have to create a free challenge, and it's got to be in your email marketing. And you're like, oh, okay, so I got to get an email marketing software. So, okay, I'm going to sign that up. And then I'm going to create this free challenge, which I'm probably going to spend a lot of time thinking about what the challenge is going to be called and what's going to go into the challenge, and also getting really, really wrapped up in the idea that this challenge needs to be really good and it needs to be life-changing in order for people to see that I'm legit. So I got to take a long time really thinking about it, researching it, putting my heart and soul into it. And oh, by the way, it's a free challenge. Let's remember that. And then you do the challenge, and that maybe it works a little bit, but you're like, okay, how am I supposed to make this sustainable? And then what else is there? You create a freebie to download off of your blog, and you talk about it on your podcast. Maybe you post about it on your many social media channels, and you do a webinar. You can see where I'm going here. Do I need to say more? Probably not. But the truth is, this is the process for 99% of individuals who are like, that online business thing looks easy, and it looks fun, and it looks fulfilling, and it looks like something I could definitely do, I'm going to do it. And then when you start doing it, you start getting so overwhelmed, and you know, so many different people and experts that are running their successful online businesses are talking about the new tactic or strategy that they're using. And so then you want to, you know, just model them and start using their strategy. And in some cases, this even ends up costing you a lot of money because you buy the courses that teach you to do this strategy, and then you have to buy the software to implement the strategy. And it just ends up getting so convoluted. It ends up being so overwhelming, and you end up having so many things to do, so many different accounts and platforms to juggle, and you're trying to be in all places at once, and finally you get to a breaking point. And if you haven't gotten there yet, maybe this podcast is going to make you stop before you get there. I definitely got to my breaking point where I was like, I'm doing all the things and I'm getting very, very, very small and little and fractional results. And so if you're there, I want to let you know that it doesn't have to be that hard. You don't have to do all the things, and actually you should be doing less than what you are doing. And that's why when I built the Wealthy Coach Blueprint, I really wanted to boil it down to the key things I did in my business that actually got results and leave out all the other things that everyone else was telling me to do. And so I was trying and it wasn't working, or I wasn't even able to figure out like if this is really working. And what a relief for me. I know my life entirely changed when I decided to strip out all of the noise of the things I was trying and just kind of go back to basics and pick one marketing funnel. And I want to reiterate that there's the general idea of a marketing funnel, which is the motive of taking someone from being a complete stranger to being a paying customer. And then ultimately, you know, maybe they will even refer other people to you and so on and so forth. But all of the different things that I mentioned in that rant that I just rattled off, those are all different little kind of strategic marketing funnels that would fit within this general motive, the general structure of a marketing funnel, taking someone from complete stranger to ultimately a paying customer. But starting the blog, doing the webinars, doing the challenges, doing all the other things and feeling like you have to juggle so many things at once or constantly be reinventing the wheel, those are like all these other little mini marketing funnels that fit within that general construct. And that's the thing that gets people really stuck, and it gets people really overwhelmed, and it also gets people like, for me, I know I was just so frustrated and tired and sick of not seeing anything work. And so the one marketing funnel that I teach inside of the blueprint boils down to two main things. It boils down to, well, it's not as easy as it sounds, but it is very simple, because it boils down to getting in front of and having great conversations with people who actually are going to be perfect clients for you. So obviously you need to identify who they are and where they hang out, which we have an entire process and a phase that you go through to do just that. But then actually having real conversations with them and also creating amazing and valuable and action-oriented content. So conversations and content. And there's a specific way that we implement this that, from my philosophy, is the idea that you don't have to be spending all of this time reinventing the wheel, creating brand new content, or, you know, taking your content and creating a challenge or creating a freebie download, or honestly, you don't even have to have a website. My philosophy in the marketing funnel that I teach, which is really, you know, if we boil it down, it's foundational business practices. But what I teach is so that you can build a business where you don't have to be having 100 hands spinning 100 different plates, and you also don't have to spend a ton of money on all these different tools and platforms and softwares. I've built my business so lean that I've been able to manage it with very, very little expenses. And for those who are just starting out in business, especially as a money coach, this is probably something that interests you. Now, there's definitely value in spending money. I've decided to prioritize, and I put a lot of value in spending money on investing in my own personal growth and learning. I make very specific decisions about who, if it's a coach, or what, if it's a program, I'm going to be investing in. And I look to do just-in-time learning specifically, so I know that it's going to be a container or a program, or I'm going to get the value out of it that I need in that moment, and then I make sure to implement upon it. And other things that I do enjoy spending money on in my business is obviously help. People who can help me do things, because that way I can take all of my energy and effort and focus on making my program better and providing my clients with an amazing experience. But other than that, there's a lot of different platforms and things that you could get invested into that you ultimately don't need. And I've definitely done that. And eventually I just had to go through like a mass exodus and delete a bunch of these subscriptions that I was paying for. And it's because I think we're constantly being sold all of these different marketing ideas and marketing ploys and things that, you know, are promised to work. And they do work. But for too many aspiring coaches or even current coaches, implementing them, they're almost implementing them at the wrong time. Before just allowing their business to be simple, allowing themselves to really do the research into who they want to sell their program to so that that can help develop their program, and then taking that and using very simple, fundamental business practices to market and sell their life-changing coaching program. So the simplest and the only marketing funnel that you need is one where you know specifically who your ideal client is. You create one high-end, high-value, high-touch coaching experience, coaching program for that ideal client, and then you go and get directly in front of them, create content specifically for that person, and have actual real-life conversations with them. And eventually, and it can happen as fast as you allow it, and sometimes it can happen, you know, after a couple days or a couple weeks or a couple months of you engaging with individuals, but eventually they're going to want to become your clients because they see the value that you are putting out. They appreciate the conversations that you're having, and they want to know more. They want to be held accountable. They're ready to make this investment in getting their life changed through working with you so that they can have a leader to guide them, and then also committing to themselves to show up. They're ready to step up and they're ready to do the work. So it's a very, very simple marketing funnel. Is it easy? It can be. I think the hardest part is about staying committed and staying focused and not getting distracted and falling victim to shiny object syndrome. I think that honestly is the hardest part of committing and staying and implementing the simple marketing funnel. But it works. And a lot of people just, you know, don't have the patience or don't have the persistence or don't have the trust in themselves to ride it out and see that it works. So that's a brief on my own personal philosophy of building business, you know, trusting that it can be simple. We can strip it down. We don't need all the fancy bells and whistles, and it doesn't have to cost a lot of money. And knowing that you can build a business by identifying and finding a mentor who's willing and able to share with you how to do it. And who has also achieved the business that you want to build. So if you're interested in joining the Wealthy Coach Blueprint for the next round, we will be opening enrollment in August. And that is a first come, first served opportunity. So make sure you jump on the waitlist by heading to wanderwealthy.com/apply. And then you will be one of the first to know and one of the first gifted with a phone call with me so we can talk more about your goals, what your obstacles might be, some strategies to overcome those, and see if the Wealthy Coach Blueprint is the right next step for you. So wanderwealthy.com/apply. Thank you so much for joining me today. I hope that this helps you see that business does not have to be overwhelming, frustrating, convoluted, very expensive. It does not. There is a simple one marketing funnel that you can implement and just trust and be committed to. If you want more from this episode, head to the show notes at wanderwealthypodcast.com/podcast/episode175 and go ahead and share with me your favorite part from this podcast or what you took away. Go to Instagram and add me at Tess_Wicks and send me a DM. I want to hear from you. I love to chat with you there. And until next time, I hope you wander wealthy.